Step 2. Creating sections and elevations. Both sections and elevations are automatically derived and updated from the central architectural design model. Their vertical and horizontal range can be carefully set, and distant areas can be defined to achieve better representation of elements in the section and elevation views. Vectorial 3D hatching, transparency, and vectorial sun shadows can all be automatically generated to achieve state-of-the-art client presentation. Switch to the first preset view in the Sections Elevations folder of the Navigator view map. Select the Section tool in the toolbox. Activate the Section 1 favorite in the Favorites palette. Enter S01 for ID and Longitudinal Section for name in the info box. Make sure that the first, so-called infinite horizontal range, and the continuous geometry method are activated in the info box. Open the Section Default Settings dialog by clicking the Settings dialog button in the info box. Review the General Settings tab page. Here you can set the ID, the name, the type, and the range of the section marker. You can also reference the marker to other existing markers by creating a linked marker or create an unlinked marker to use textual information. The controls of the Story Levels panel can be used to define the display of the story level lines and story handle markers on the given section view. This training guide will discuss these settings in later steps. Make sure in the standard toolbar that guidelines are enabled. Place a section line by first clicking at the point of label 1.1, then at the point of label 1.2, to create a longitudinal section line. Click a third time at label 1.3 to define the direction in which the section will look. Zoom into the section label to get a clearer view about its content. Right-click the section line to select it and bring up the context menu. Select Open Section to have a look at the new section view. Switch off the grid display from the view menu. Zoom in and scroll to see the details if necessary. Go back to the floor plan view and select the section line if it is not selected already. We want this section to be broken at 2 points so it crosses 2 staircases of the building. To achieve this, we need to edit the section line. Select the next preset view in the view map. Click at the hotspot of the section line near label 4. This is also the halving point of the line. Choose the Break Section Elevation Line option from the appearing PET palette. Click at the point of label 1.5 to break the section line and lower its right part. Click the halving hotspot of the new vertical section line segment near the point of label 1.6. Make sure that the Move Section Elevation Line Segment option is still selected in the PET palette. Click again at the point of label 1.7 to move the section line break a bit to the left. Select the next preset view in the view map. We will break this section line at another point also. Make sure that the S1 section line is still selected, or select it if necessary. Click at the halving hotspot of the section line near the label 1.8. Activate the Break Section Elevation Line option from the PET palette, and then click at the point of label 1.9 to break the section line again and lower its right part. Click the halving hotspot of the vertical segment near the point of label 1.10. Make sure that the Move Section Elevation Line Segment option is selected in the PET palette. Click again at the point of label 1.11 to move the section line break a bit to the left. With these two modifications, the longitudinal section goes through both staircases. This is exactly what we wanted to achieve. Open the modified S1 section to check the changes. Go back to the floor plan view and deselect the S1 section line. activate the next preset view in the view map. Activate the Section 2 favorite in the Favorites palette. Enter a cross-section for name, and make sure that ID is set to S2 in the info box. Also, make sure that the infinite horizontal range and continuous geometry method are both selected in the info box. Place a section line by first clicking at the point of label 1.1, then at the point of label 1.2 to create a cross-section line. Give a third click at label 1.3 to define the direction in which the section will look. Activate the next preset view in the view map and the corresponding section favorite in the Favorites palette. Go to the info box and make sure that ID is set to S3, the name is set to cross-section, the horizontal range is set to limited, and geometry method is set to continuous. In the case of this section, we want to limit the depth of the section so that we do not have distant building elements causing confusion in the section view. Place a section line by first clicking at the point of label 1.1, then at the point of label 1.2 to create a cross-section line. Give a third click at label 1.3 to define the direction and the depth of the section. This time, the third click will define the depth limit of the section too. We will now create the elevations. Activate the next preset view in the view map. Select the elevation tool in the toolbox. Activate the Elevation 1 favorite in the Favorites palette. Check the info box and make sure that the E1 is entered for ID and East Elevation is entered for name. Click at the points of labels 1.1, 1.2, and 1.3 to define the directions and depths of the elevations. Continue creating the elevations by activating preset views 6.2.7 to 6.2.11. Always activate the favorites called for by the view names. Check the info box and make sure that E2 is entered for the ID. Enter North Elevation for elevation name. Make sure to use the appropriate ID and name for the elevations. Enter the appropriate elevation names as you see it in this movie, or please find them in the PDF ebook of this guide. Click at the points of labels 1.1, 1.2, and 1.3 to define the directions and depths of the elevations. Activate the 6.2.12 preset view in the view map. Shift-click to select the elevation near label 1.1. As you can see, there are two lines showing the depth of the elevation. Both have hotspots at the middle. The farther one is the horizontal depth of the elevation. The one closer to the elevation line is called the distant area depth line. Elements in the distant area can be displayed differently. For example, with a uniform lighter surface color to make it visually easier to distinguish and give additional depth to sections or elevations. Go to the Elevation Selection Settings dialog and expand the Model Display Panel. Scroll down to the Mark Distant Area settings. Here, you can set the same settings for distant area as for normal uncut surfaces. For example, the vectorial 3D hatching for distant surfaces can be switched on to achieve greater graphical distinction and to achieve a nicer presentation. Click Cancel to leave the dialog. Click the middle of the distant area line near label 1.2. Choose Move Section Elevation Line Segment from the appearing PET palette. Click near label 1.3 to move the elevation line segment further away from the elevation line, thereby including more parts of the building in the non-distant portion of the elevation. Press Escape to deselect the elevation, or click elsewhere on the floor plan for the same result. activate the next preset view in the view map. Right-click the elevation line near label 1.1, then select Open Elevation from the context menu to open the elevation window. Switch off the grid display from the view menu. You can see in the elevation that the grid lines are visible. These are the same grid lines we created in Chapter 2. Also, you can see story level lines. These can also be displayed in each individual section, elevation, or interior elevation. Right-click and select Elevation Settings from the context menu to open the Elevation Selection Settings dialog. In the dialog, expand the Grid Tool panel. The Grid Tool panel shows settings that determine how the grid placed on the first floor plan appears in this elevation. You can select grid elements to be displayed based on the story upon which they are placed or their name. You can also display dimensions at a total dimension of the grid. Expand the Story Levels panel of the dialog. Here, you can set each section elevation or interior elevation to display horizontal lines that mark each story level for easy referencing. Besides the lines, a name and a level value may also be displayed for each level. Expand the Model Display panel of the dialog. Here you can set the settings that affect how the model will be displayed in the elevation view. Let's take a look at a couple of settings and their effects. Under Uncut Elements, set the Fill Uncut Surfaces With field to Uniform Pen Color. Set Uncut Surfaces Pen to Pen 108. Once you're done, click OK to accept the changes and leave the dialog. Right-click and choose Rebuild from Model in the context menu. As you can see, all uncut surfaces of the elevation are filled with a uniform color. Open the Elevation Settings dialog again. Under Uncut Elements, set the Fill Uncut Surfaces With field to Own Material Colors, Shaded. This was the original setting of the elevation. Click the OK button to accept changes. Rebuild the elevation once again by activating the Rebuild From Model option from the context menu. You can also experiment with various other settings, such as transparency and vectorial sun shadows. Feel free to try the settings we didn't cover in the last steps. Right-click and select Go To Floor Plan from the context menu to return to the floor plan. Click elsewhere to deselect the section line. Switch to the project map in the navigator. In the Sections viewpoint group, right-click the S2 cross-section. Select Open from the context menu to open the section. Sections have settings similar to those of elevations, including distant area, transparency, vectorial 3D hatching, and vectorial sun shadows. Make sure that View Grid Display is switched off. Activate the Design Solid Element Operations command to bring up the Solid Element Operation palette. Move the palette to the right side of the screen, next to the Navigator palette. Zoom in to the third floor of the section. If you zoom in a bit more to the dissected walls located on the third floor, you'll see that their bottoms are at the top of the structure of the slab below the third floor. Also, they cut into the floor skins of the slab composite structure. We will use SEO to correct these intersections. Shift-click the slab below Story 3 to select it. Click the Get Target Elements button in the SEO palette. Click elsewhere to deselect the slab. Make sure the groups are suspended. Select the three interior walls of the third floor you see in this section. Click the Get Operator Elements button in the SEO palette. In the SEO palette, select Subtraction in the Choose an Operation field. Click the Execute button to cut the bodies of the three walls out of the body of the slab into which they extend. The Rebuilt section shows the result of the solid element operation. This operation can be performed both in the 3D window as well as in all other model viewpoints. Do the same subtraction operation in the three other stories. First, select the appropriate slab below the story and define it as the target element. Select all the walls intersecting the slab. And define them as operators. Finally, execute the subtraction operation and investigate the results. Do the same subtraction with the slab above the third floor where the two parapet walls cut into the body of the slab. Select the slab and define it as the target element. Select both parapet wall segments and define them as operator elements. Execute the subtraction operation. Investigate the results of the last operation. Close the SEO palette to remove it from the screen